all, welcome back to another splendid episode of Candid Conversations with Rola. And just like the last time, I am here with another beautiful co-host. And today, we'll be talking about another grand topic. But before then, as usual, let's introduce myself.
Hi, my name is Ola Shubom, and I'm an entrepreneur.
So, on today's show, we'll be talking about what I ordered versus what I got. I know everyone has been on this table at one point of your life or the other, maybe with your tailor, your hairstylist, you know, IG vendor. It could have been anybody, it could have been you. I have been on this table several times, and I don't know about you. Let me ask her, have you ever ordered something online, or you ever wanted something and then you got another thing entirely?
Yes, it happened to me. She didn't just change the style, she destroyed the style. The pocket was somewhere else. The V-neck was not V-neck, it was like S-neck. As I was so disappointed. I could not even manage that dress. Like, I just had to do it. Till now, I just want to lose. I can't wait.
You know, I am also an entrepreneur. I also have an IG page where I sell things. I am always careful of this situation because I also don't want a situation whereby someone
it was clear that she was disappointed. Mm-hmm. Because I'm sure the tailor she got, this tailor must have been a tailor right from time. So I don't know what happened. Or maybe she changed that tailor. I really don't know.
True. What about that one of NK? I think I prefer Niniola's disaster.
Niniola's
disaster was better than
exactly
that.
NK was a disappointment. I was extremely disappointed. Because this, I'm sure the person I ordered for that particular dress must have paid probably 15,000, 20k. What would I pay 20k for a dress that came out to be like 5k clothes? I'm sure I'm going to kill her. I'm going to strip
First
her.
First of all, the measurement, the size, everything was just off. Everything about that
was not at all. There was also one I saw on Instagram one time. One girl ordered for a particular weave, and the weave was around 90k or so, thereabouts. When they brought it, the weave was looking like this weave is 5k.
There was one I saw with this popular IG vendor. I don't want to mention names yet because I don't think that's proper. But she's really popular. You know, she sells hair, it's really popular. And someone ordered hair from her. Trust me, this is not just any kind of hair. You know, this bohemian curls, frontal. I think the hair was about 150k.
Wow.
She ordered for the one of 24 inches. So when the hair got to her after a very long time, she discovered it was not even curly enough. That was not what she wanted. And then instead of 24 inches, she got 20 inches.
Wow.
So she got back to the vendor like, what is this? Number one, it's not even the same inches with what I wanted. Only for this vendor to say, it is. Use staple and measure it.
Seriously?
You said use staple.
No. Do you know something about those who, when they find out that what they've done is wrong, and they keep on calling them auntie? What I ordered was not
apologetic.
It should just be switched off.
Yeah.
Because if they did that, another was switched off when the girl found out that this was not what she ordered for.
Then the thing is that, you see, some of these people, they have people around them, even friends that are into this kind of business, that could easily do the same job, do it well, but they would rather patronize popular IG vendors because of tags, you know, add something,
add this.
So people can be like,
that's true.
So, and then when things when they come out to complain. We're not saying you shouldn't patronize these people, but know who you are buying from. There are some IG vendors that are notorious for stuff like this. People are always calling them out. I got this, I ordered that, this and that. So, you know, just try and make your findings. Know who you are getting your product from, and just, you know, be careful. I don't think I've ever ordered something online and then I got something.
Well, I think also it's not just about maybe clothes or hair.
Yes, it could be any
food.
Food.
And that one, sure. No, I've seen it somewhere where someone ordered for a particular cake. That cake was
especially
was
cake.
What she like this cake was it was this cake. And then when they brought the cake, girl was calling that. Are you sure this was the cake? Nah, man, this cannot be the cake.
Exactly.
Because she was very disappointed that this cannot be the cake. So it's not just even small chops. Mm-hmm. If nothing were some people like, oh, look at this.
Even chicken.
The chicken
pie that one of chicken.
My nose would be
pictured. What she saw was well edited, very fat chicken, and then this thing came, she was already prepared to, you know,
devour it and all.
Only for this chicken to come and it's looking like chicken wings, you know. And then she told this person that, look, this was not what I saw. Only for this girl to be like, you know, ignore it. You know these things now. I'm like, yeah. It's edited, like iPhone edit. Just. She was like, this is the same chicken that was on my page. The only difference was that I edited it. So, they're also guilty of that. They over edit some pictures. Most times it is actually the same product that you bought.
Yeah.
But then because of over editing, now when you get it, it's not looking like the same
thing. Yeah, that's true.
There are some times that you edit something and then the picture changes. Mm-hmm. It happens. Like at the end of the day, black is looking white. It's really funny.
Should I really blame? You know some people, they actually get photographers that snap.
Yes, they are.
They don't use their phone.
Yes.
Not everyone
yes.
That
no.
So should I can't blame the photographer for
I cannot.
I'm sorry, because it's not the photographer that is.
I can't blame the customer.
I can't blame the customer and I can't blame the photographer. I'll blame the person that owns that thing. That
exactly.
That is doing that thing.
Same here.
That
same
is selling
here.
That product. Mm-hmm.
I can't blame the customer truly because you're trying to support a business. And it's left for the vendor to, you know, satisfy the customer. Most people, I think the money comes first before the customer satisfaction.
But my concern is this. Why would I want to give my customer a bad feeling about me?
Why exactly. In this social media age, where bad news travels really fast.
Like SK, if I... So it's very
now, really, true.
For my birthday, I was thinking, should I order from
But now
I don't want to be a
thief.
I just rather sew my clothes at my tailor's place. I rather go through the meat. But I can even take a picture of what she get the material so much she's sewing at my tailor's place. Instead of NK to give me the size of a size 4 or a size 20.
So anyway, I guess that brings us to the end of today's show. Let us know if you've ever ordered something online and then getting to you, it was something else entirely. I'm sure if it has not happened to you, it has clearly or surely happened to someone close to you, a family member, a friend. Drop your suggestions, let us know how we dealt with the situation later. And till next week, as usual, stay safe and stay blessed. And do not forget to subscribe.